guys, it's Katie here with Life in Mundane, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm excited to share with you guys what we got our six kids in their stockings this year. I'm gonna show you guys how we do this with six kids and how we do it somewhat affordably. So I'm excited to share with you and hopefully give you some tips and tricks. So let's get started. Hi, my name is Katie, and welcome to Life in the Mundane. I am second generation homeschool mom of six beautiful kiddos. And on this channel, we talk all things resources. I love to share with you resources that are gonna help you in your homeschooling and help encourage you in your biblical parenting and how you can utilize those to their fullest potential so that you can make the most of the little moments. This video is actually done in collaboration with my dear friend Yasmin from Mommy on the Move. Yasmin's channel is full of inspiration for your homeschool. She shares about homeschool resources, curriculum reviews, lots of book hauls, and fun things like that. So you will be sure to love it, I know. So be sure to check out her link down in the description below to follow her channel and then also check out the playlist of all the other moms sharing their stockings. I have kids ranging in age from 12-year-olds down to 3-year-olds. We've got a mixture of boys and girls, so there really is ideas here for everyone. I'm going to show you a few things that we get in all of our kids' stockings, and then I will show you each individual kids so that you kind of have more age-specific ideas. The first thing that we do in everybody's stocking is that we get each of our kids an electric toothbrush. This is just a fun little thing that we can do. We get a pattern they like or maybe a different character that they like. Also, a lot of times our Walmart will have sales on these right before the Christmas season, so we try to grab them in advance for only a couple of bucks, but it's just something that makes it kind of extra fun and special they look forward to each year. The next thing is, I was trying to figure out how to deal with the sweets problem, right? We get so many candies and cookies and things like that, and they have all these treats at every event we go to around the holiday season. And so I didn't really want to contribute with a lot of extra candy. We also have kids who are very sugar sensitive. I'm not against it whatsoever, but I just was trying to find an alternative. So years ago, we started a new family fun tradition that was to get a box of Pop-Tarts for each of my kids. It's still something sweet and delicious. It's definitely a treat because we never buy them normally, but it's just kind of a fun breakfast and they each get their own box. We don't worry about assigning a specific box per kid. I just get one, I lay them out in each stocking and they can swap or trade. There's multiple packages in a box so they can swap out and get one of each or however they want to do. I kind of leave it up to them, but it is something they really look forward to and keeps me from having to stick any extra sugar in their stocking. So those are the things that I keep for each of their stockings. The other little tip or trick, if you guys need to know, is as I lay out all their stockings, once I finalize what everybody's getting, I store them in a box in my closet in individual Walmart bags. So one child's stockings all go into one bag. That makes it really easy the night before to pull out and lay out. I don't have to resort because I would find out years after that I'd be like, oh, where did I put this and where did I put that? Makes it so much easier. All right, so first we're gonna start with youngest and work our way to the oldest. You definitely are gonna wanna stick around because I know the older kids are always hard to buy for and I've got a lot of ideas. I'm gonna show you guys my two youngest ones. We have a 3-year-old and a 4-year-old girl, and theirs are very similar. There are some minor differences, but the first thing that we started out with was little drawing sketchbooks from Dollar Tree. One has a panda on it, which my daughter's obsessed with pandas. The other one has lollipops on it. Who doesn't love lollipops? And they've just got fun, like drawing sketch pages and notebooks. They love to feel older, so we got one of these from the Dollar Tree for each of them. Also from the Dollar Tree, we got each of them their own hairbrushes. Every year, all of my girls get hairbrushes in their stockings because these are a hot commodity when you have five women living in one house. I was also able to snag these cute little sunglasses and sunglass holders for only a dollar at our Walmart earlier in the season at the end of summer, and I know that they're gonna love them. They turn into cute little like purses for them. I got one for each of them. Also from Dollar Tree, I was able to pick up these cute little picture frames. They've got stands on the back and they had these Mickey Mouse paints because they're both obsessed with Mickey Mouse. I thought this would be a fun art craft project for them to do. And then they can put the picture of their choice in the middle. Another clearance find, don't worry, I will take the clearance stickers off before I give them to them, is we found for $1.50 each, we found these cute little hair kits. So we've got some clips and some scrunchies in here for each of the girls. Also, they always want to be like their older sisters, and so I got them each a lip gloss and a very small container of fingernail polish from the Dollar Tree. They really wanted fingernail polish. They are not gonna have open access to this. This is gonna be something that is special to do with mommy, but I did not want it to be a large bottle because I did not want it to get spilled or ruin anything, and so yep, we got one for each of them. Another affordable option that we found years ago that our kids absolutely love is to get the little ones character Band-Aids from Dollar Tree. My kids, again, we get regular plain boring Band-Aids, and little ones always love to put Band-Aids on everything. Way excessive usage, right? But now they can have their own Scooby-Doo Band-Aids, and they can use them however if they want. They can use them all one day if they want, and they usually do. But just something fun extra to add into their stocking. We also got these little sticker packs. I got these, I think, at Walmart for like a dollar or so about a year ago. And they've just got fun little stickers, unicorns and puppy dogs and things like that. So we split up the pack and put a few in each girl's stocking. The last thing is we got this fun Bluey and Bingo set. They came in a box together. They were, again, marked down on clearance for only, I think, a dollar, maybe $2. So we bought it, we opened it up and split it, so they'll each get one. And last but not least, a few more scrunchies. So a while back, probably 2 years ago now, I got an amazing deal on Amazon for a big bag of these fun scrunchies. And it was like 90 scrunchies for, I think it was like $3 to $5, something like that. So I picked it up, and I love having these, and my girls absolutely love them. I picked up a big bag of them, and every year we throw in a few new ones into their stocking. I have thrown them into gifts for friends, lots of fun things. We just keep using them, and the gift that keeps on giving. All right, next up is my older girls. They are 9 and 10 years old. There are a few things that overlap and a few things that are more to their individual tastes or styles. We started out with another Dollar Tree find. I don't like to get everything at Dollar Tree because I don't want just like a lot of junk that's gonna break very easily, but Dollar Tree really does have some great finds for you and your kids. So we got these fun little journals from there. We got hairbrushes for each of them, and we got a picture frame for each of them because I knew they would enjoy doing it as well as some nicer, more adult paintbrushes. They're always looking for paintbrushes in our house. We have lots of nice paints, like not like the Mickey Mouse ones that I showed you earlier. So I didn't buy them paints for it because we already have a good stock of them, but they'll be able to design these and decorate in their room. Also on Amazon this year, I was able to snag this big package of Baby Groot stickers, Mandalorian stickers, and all of my older kids are obsessed with Mandalorian. So we divided these up between all four of the big kids, so they each are gonna get a few stickers. They can decorate their binders with them or whatever they wanna do with them. I also got each of the older girls their own lip gloss, a little bit older, and their own real fingernail polish, which they'll be excited about. Of course, they have their own scrunchies to throw in there, their own toothbrushes, their Pop-Tarts, of course, and then we got them each an activity kit for their stockings. For my oldest daughter, we got her the Star Wars cross-stitch kit that we got from Book Outlet. It gives her several different designs that she can do. It gives her the supplies to do, I think, up to 2 designs, but then she can take the pattern book and use it to put things on whatever she wants. So I just thought that'd be a fun little extra thing for them, and they had it so incredibly cheap on Book Outlet. For my 9-year-old, she has really gotten into these rainbow looms, so we got her one of these fun kits. Actually, this was something that someone gave us that their daughter had bought and never used, and so it's brand new, but it'll be something that'll be great to add to her stocking. And then for my 9-year-old also, and the only reason she's getting this and the older one is not, is because the older one does not have her ears pierced, but the 9-year-old does. And so I got her these cute little birdie earrings, these purple birdie earrings. I got them at a craft fair for paparazzi. They were selling them for only a dollar a piece, so I just thought it'd be fun extra to throw in her gift. Now that brings me to the boys. We have an 11 and 12 year old boys, and I found this year to be incredibly, incredibly challenging because boys are just harder to buy for in general, right? You can't get cute hair, you know, hair ties and fingernail polish and things like that. And also they're just like, the little stuff at Dollar Tree wasn't cutting it. So I did get a few things at Dollar Tree, and I'm gonna show you guys that. I got these fun pins that were on carabiners, and they like have like that stretch pull, I don't know what the term is. Oh, retractable, that would be the term. A retractable pin here that I thought would be fun for when they're out on adventures, when they're playing spies, things like that. So thought that would be just kind of fun extra that I got at Dollar Tree. And then my other Dollar Tree find is that my oldest son has his own YouTube channel and is all about filming and recording and things like that. And I found this really cool clapper, and it's actually like wooden. It's made that you can like set it up as a decor thing, but it is actually a chalkboard surface, so he could write on it and use it. So I found that at Dollar Tree and thought that was a perfect addition to his stocking. Again, they each have their Mandalorian stickers that they're gonna be excited about. And then I was able to get each of them a book. This one is from Usborne, it's Axel and the Beast. My son loves these series, and we were able to get this for free from hosting a book party through Usborne. Yasmin from Mommy on the Move, who actually is the collab host of this, is actually an Usborne consultant. And so I hosted a party with her and was able to get this completely free for my kid's stocking. And this is Who Was George Lucas, who is the creator of Star Wars, in case you didn't know. And of course, my kids are obsessed with Star Wars. So I got this for my older son from Book Outlet for only like $2 or $3. Another thing we love to buy in bulk and separate up are these off-brand Nerf darts. If you guys are not using off-brand Nerf darts, you need to be using them. Oh my gosh, they're amazing. You can buy them on Amazon. There's different prices. I'll link them down below. But you can get like big bulks, like 500 or 1,000 darts. And they're super, super, super cheap. Way cheaper than the name brand. I will tell you though, they do have a rubber tip on them. Sometimes they can be a little bit harder than the other ones. We always use eye protection and things like that. But what's cool is you can buy this big bulk box and they come in individual wrapping bags of 10. So we got 40 for each of our boys. And then I was actually able to split off some of the other ones that we got in our package to give to nephews. We also are able to get them another gift for each of them on Book Outlet, and that is a spy and espionage kit. This one has a book in it, as well as sunglasses and a decoder wheel, and there's a magnifying glass and some fake ID cards and just fun things that I thought my 11-year-old would like. And for my 12-year-old, since I said he's into YouTube and filming, this is the Vlogger's Handbook. It's got all fun instructions on how to do different vlog shots, how to set up your shots, what to do post-production, all the fun stuff. Wrapping it up here with the last couple of things, I got each of the boys their own card game. I was able to grab these on Amazon really cheap during Black Friday. We've got Minecraft Uno, and we have got Pictionary cards, which I'd never heard of this before, but essentially all of the pictures are already drawn for you, and then it's almost like charades and Pictionary mixed together. So this, for instance, this clue, you got wavy lines and a man and a rectangle, but this clue is like a diving board, so that you would show this card jumping off this card into this card. Does that make sense? So it's supposed to be kind of fun. I don't know. I think my son will love it. So we got both of these for them. And then we also got them each. We got them new pocket knives. They have had pocket knives before. They've proven themselves very responsible. So we were excited to get them another set because they were really wanting one that was just a little bit older. We're excited to give them those. We got those off Amazon. This was the most expensive purchase of the entire stocking shabam whatsoever, but we felt like they were a little bit older. We wanted to give them something a little bit nicer, and I know they'll be excited about it. And that's all I've got for my stockings. I hope this video was fun, exciting, and give you a few ideas of ways that you can affordably find things for your kiddos. I hope you guys have an amazing Christmas, and again, be sure to check out the playlist of all the videos down below, and we'll talk to you again soon. Bye.